Hello, my name is Leah and welcome to my channel Create with Leah. What we're going to create in this channel is mainly digital products. But before we get started with digital products, I would like to introduce you to five channels that helped me to earn my first digital income, online income. So basically, I've been working full-time in London in digital marketing, and I've been thinking, like, was I born for that? Do I have to always work 9 to 5? There is no escape and I have to work like this until the, I don't know, pension? Like, is it gonna be all my life? So I thought I need to find some other thing, you know, some other income, side hustle, so I can actually escape from the rat race. Well, that was in 2014. There are not so many people been thinking about escaping rat race. Right now it's more popular, but still, you know, I've been trying to discover some income, you know, something that I can actually start working on. So I've discovered Udemy.com. Udemy is a place where you create a lot of online courses. I mean, you can create a course on any topic. My first courses were about marketing, but later on, I started creating courses about insomnia, about things like morning routine, my meditation in the morning, and things like that. So about freelancing as well. And those courses are quite popular, right? But in 2020, when the pandemic started, Udemy decided to shut me down. And they did it because I never used my own voice. Can you imagine that? I've created so many courses, but I never used my voice and I never used my face. I was so camera shy that I've been using slides most of the time, and I've been hiring voiceover artists. And Udemy said, no, you have to use your own voice. You can't use third-party voice, right? So what I did is I put all these courses into my Skillshare, and I started earning from Skillshare as well. From Skillshare, I've been earning around $1,000. I'm saying I've been earning because Skillshare now is changing the policy as well. They don't want third-party voice. They want your voice. So then I thought, I mean, if I have to use my voice and I have to be on camera, why do I stay in Udemy or Skillshare? Because in Udemy and Skillshare, people will never discover you. There are so many courses out there. I mean, they will discover you only if they pay for that course. So I thought, I mean, I want to be on YouTube, right? Because on YouTube, it's free. So people can discover me on YouTube and they can actually, they don't have to pay for it, and I will be visible, right? While on Udemy, you are not visible. However, on Udemy, you're actually earning income. That's passive income. And on Skillshare as well. So that's how I started doing courses. I mean, in 2014, I joined Udemy and I've created so many courses. Right now, I don't have so many courses. I have only a couple of courses that I sell, and those courses are about creating courses. I have a channel, second channel, called Course Hustle. In there, I show all my hustle, I mean, everything that I've done for creating courses. Now I concentrate mainly on Etsy because my main income at the moment is Etsy, and I create digital products. This time around, you don't need any voice. You don't have to be on camera. You don't have to use a voiceover artist. Because you can create digital products and you can sell them on Etsy without being on camera. Okay? So basically, on Etsy, I sell digital products like workbooks, worksheets, cheat sheets, planners, ebooks, all kind of digital products that you can imagine. I have a Etsy starter pack that I can link below if you are interested. But at the moment, I work with coaches most of the time because I know coaches. I've been coached myself, and it's very difficult for coaches to create digital products while you're serving clients, because your clients, you have to, you know, spend time with them. You cannot just sit down and figure out Canva, right? So for that, I've created so many templates that you don't have to go and figure out something. You can just buy and customize it with your own logo, etc., and color and branding. So that's Etsy. Then I also tried Fiverr.com. I've tried Fiverr a little bit earlier than now. At the moment, there is a huge competition on Fiverr. But when I tried that, I actually been on Fiverr until 2019, and I had very stable income from there. I had clients that were coming back to me. I've been offering social media services like creating designs, captions, writing emails and things like that. I mean, on Fiverr, I've been getting paid $150 per client. So if I had 10 clients that month, I would get $1,500, which is nothing in Malta, because I've been living in Malta at that time. And because it's a euro country, $1,500 become 1,300 euro, which is the minimum salary in Malta. So then I also discovered Upwork. Upwork, more or less similar to Fiverr, but it's more like you find, instead of clients, you work with an employer. So basically, somebody will hire you for a long-term project, and that project can be 12 months, and you work for that company. So they can give you a salary. Salary can, you know, depend on the company. So from $500 to $5,000, but you are tied with that company. You can have two projects, you can have three projects, it's okay. But then, would you have enough time for all these three projects? So instead of one boss, when you work for a company, you have one boss, you're gonna have three bosses. On Fiverr, because I have 10 clients per month, I have 10 bosses. So that's more or less like an active type of income, while this is passive type of income. And I love this three passive type of income, because you create your product once and you earn every month. But again, you have to be still active in here. Like, you have to give the customer service, you have to respond to messages, you have to respond to reviews, you have to, you know, solve problems for clients if they have some problem with your product, or you have to work with them if they want some custom order. So basically, these are five platforms that I earn income from. So here, it starts from $500 per month. This starts from, I don't know how much is the expectation for Skillshare, but I've been earning $1,000 a month. Etsy, last month I cashed in to $11,000. So that's more or less something you can expect from Etsy. Fiverr, I've been earning up to $2,000 on Fiverr, and Upwork I gave up after one project, so I cannot really tell you how much you can earn on Upwork. Well, that's it for today. I hope you liked these five platforms and you're gonna go and discover them. I'm not sure if you know about these platforms or you've just heard about them, but I hope it helps. So thank you very much for watching this video till the end. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe. See you. Bye bye.